you shamed with your old GoPros?
I was shamed with my old GoPros, so I bought two new Hero 12 Black S XLS LE, something like that. And we haven't done any filming for the last 3 days, but we have been working on the boat nonstop in St. Martin. It was our first trip since the big party. And we're getting off the dock today. We're going to go anchor in French Side, and then we're going to head to BBI tomorrow, which is about a 90-mile crossing. So we're going through the famous bridge.
Let's show this. So this is the busiest week of yachting in St. Martin. So the bridge, you know, we have to wait for. All the boats are trying to get out, probably all headed for St. Bart's for New Year's. So there was, I think, 12 yachts lined up coming out of this bridge today. So we're actually gonna anchor because we didn't have time to get fuel. So we're gonna anchor and take the dinghy in and just get a couple of jugs of fuel.
We are anchored in Grand Cass, which we sailed to yesterday, had just an amazing sail. Upwind, going about 3/4 of the speed of the wind, into the wind, and we sailed all the way to Grand Cass. It was a really great sail. It was only 10 miles. We had dinner at a great restaurant on the beach over here called Rainbow. This is Grand Cass. There's about 50 restaurants along here. But now it's time to get our sail on. So we are raising the anchor and getting ready to head 100 miles to the British Virgin Islands. So we hoisted the mainsail, which went perfectly. It's a roller furling boom, so this takes getting used to. But there's little to no wind right now. There should be 10 knots in a little while, so we'll probably put up the spinnaker. I thought I would never do that with Lenny and I alone because it's such a big sail, 2,500 square feet. A light wind day like this, the spinnaker could be the difference between motoring or sailing. We'd rather sail, so I think we're gonna put it up. Lenny and I know how to sail a boat. Right? It's like swinging a golf club, but then you take a lifetime to master it. So this is the chart of all of the sails we have on Happy Together. And this is our jib, and this is our J0. Both of those sails are furled, and they live up on the forestay. My J0, I can sheet it outboard and have a bigger angle. So that sail has the most angle. But right now, the apparent wind is at 95. And the A2, which is our monster spinnaker, is designed to fly from 80 degrees to about 130, okay? It's a very narrow range compared to these other sails. In these conditions, that's the sail that'll give us the most bang for our buck. So it's a monster, and we've flown it when we have crew aboard. We've never flown it with just Lenny and I. But in fact, I think I said...
You would never fly it with just...
I said I would never fly it with just Lenny and I.
So here we are.
Spinnaker sheet goes all the way to the back of the boat, back by the flag. The spinnaker sheet will be outboard of the shrouds here, go back there, and then it leads back through and comes back to this winch. we've checked all this to make sure we're doing it right. We even opened up the manual from Kinetic to make sure we can use that red halyard, because you can also use the green halyard for spinnakers. We're using the red one because it doesn't have a lock at the top, so it's more of a simple halyard. There's not a lot of wind, only 10 knots. Okay, we feel confident with all our checks. And remember, for those of you who have watched us sail 20,000 miles, this is a different boat, different rig, and everything is huge, right? So it's like going from your car to a Formula One car. Everything's different. So we're just having to double check all our thought processes. But now we're gonna launch the chute. Remember, it's 2,441 square feet.
It's an apartment.
It's now or never.
Spinnaker's out.
So here's our update. We're motoring with both engines going 8 knots while we were setting this up. And there's only 10 knots of wind. And normally we'd never be able to sail in that. We are currently going 9 knots in 10.2 knots of wind with this spinnaker up.
Crazy.
Look at this beast. Now, we're playing with the trim because we don't really know exactly how to trim this sail. So what we're doing is just trial and error. We have to prevent the luff from collapsing. So I'm steering a course to keep that luff. It's not attached to anything. So I gotta keep that full so it's not falling in. See how it's falling in a little up there? And so I just gotta steer a course and adjust my spinnaker sheet to keep the sail full. And the fuller you can keep it without slatting means you have better boat speed. And this is all about boat speed. But I gotta show you the numbers because they're remarkable. This is really remarkable. We're doing 9 knots in 10.8 knots of wind, and the boat is just humming. We thought we were only gonna have this sail up for a few minutes, and we're sailing the entire route with this sail up. And so we feel like freaking geniuses now. Of course, we haven't put it away yet. Usually a challenge. And right now you can't see, but I can see Virgin Gorda, which is 36 miles away, and I can also see St. Martin, which is 40 miles away. This is known as the longest run in the Caribbean between the islands because it's almost 100 miles, and I just find it fascinating on a clear blue day like today with low humidity that in the middle you can see both mountains, because the mountains are 3,000 feet tall. Virgin Gorda I think is 1,400 feet tall. So what seems to be a big scary body of water that people are always nervous about, we're standing in the middle and we're looking at both islands. So it's just kind of crazy. What a sailing day. And now it's lunch.
Lunch time.
For those of you who follow the whole wind speed thing, we're currently going 8.5 knots in 8.9 knots of wind. I get the boat trimmed just right, I can get the wind speed and the boat speed within 10% of each other, let's say. This whole day would have been a motoring day. It's just very calm conditions today. And for this big, huge catamaran to be able to move like this is just remarkable. So now Lenny is online with the BBI doing something called, what is it called?
Sail clear, checking us in online.
Yeah, so that's pretty cool. Most of the paperwork is now online. You still have to show up and show your faces. The boat is still moving along great, and that's Virgin Gorda right ahead of us there. We've had the spinnaker up all day, and it has just been no problem. We haven't even had to play with the sail trim. What we do in this situation, if you're racing, you would be aiming for a mark and adjusting your sheets constantly to maximize your sail trim. But on a 90-mile course like this, we just followed the wind, you know, and knew that it might add a couple miles to our trip. But rather than constantly maintaining the sail, we just let the boat steer with the wind. and keep the sail trim that way. So we literally haven't touched the spinnaker sheet. Like today, with 9 to 10 knots of wind, I expected this to be a motorboat trip, because it always would have been before. And to have this boat just ghosting along at 8 knots comfortably all day without the engines on is just magic. And why we made this choice. Oops. There's a squall coming. That's not good. That is a rain squall coming. So now Lenny and I have a decision to make. So I'm gonna look at the radar and see what that looks like. If it looks like it's gonna be packing wind over 20 knots, then we gotta douse this thing. We wanna be cautious. We don't wanna damage anything. My ego, one, the sail, two, and any of the gear or hardware, but mostly my ego. I get knocked down, but I get up again. So now we started the engine and put the boat in gear just as a precaution in case we have some drama putting the sail away, that we're ready to power up if we need to. But we've steered away from the wind to take pressure off the sail. So it should be real easy to roll this in now. Now we're going to Sabre Rock for the big New Year's party. Is this a dinghy dance?
It's a dinghy dance.
Go ahead. I'm really into garbage management. When I say into it, I mean like when I wake up in the morning, sometimes she's just looking at me, and as soon as I open my eyes, she says, "We gotta get rid of the trash." She doesn't like to have trash on the boat. I don't know if we've ever talked about this before. So here we are at Bitter End, and I've got a bag of trash that I brought with me, hoping we could drop it somewhere here. Here's my bag of trash. Just one bag. There's plenty of places on the boat to store it, where it's out of the way and you can store it for a week. Not her. She wants the trash off the boat. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Trash is gone.
Trash is gone.
Trash is gone.
I manage the trash at home.
You do manage the trash at home.
And I do it well, and I manage the trash. That's just one of my jobs, trash management.
It should be my job.
No, because you are not interested in trash management.
I am not interested.
I'm highly interested.
I am not interested in it. So it's important we do things that align with our interests.
Exactly. That's what makes it better.
This is the Bitter End Yacht Club. It was destroyed during Hurricane Irma, and it is so beautiful now. it's like three bars and three restaurants and great shops and a market.
I'm gonna lay in this hammock and Lenny's gonna come out of the bathroom, and my guess is that she's gonna walk right past because she's not gonna think that it's me laying in a hammock. The reason is because I never lay in hammocks. I have a fear of them because I laid in one once when I was a kid and it broke and I hit the ground and busted my tailbone. So before I got in this hammock, I inspected the rigging to make sure that I wasn't going to have a repeat performance. Okay, here she comes.
Why do you have the camera there?
Because I just thought you'd walk right by me because you would assume I'm not laying in a hammock. And
you're usually afraid of hammocks.
I just told that story to the GoPro that I have a real,
you have a real
fear.
Hammock problem.
So there's another hammock story that happened right here in Bitter End 25 years ago.
Yeah.
Lenny and I were on our first charter. We chartered a 32-foot monohull. It was called Sail Away. It was a Beneteau. We rented it from the moorings. And we sailed up here. And we were kids. We didn't know what the heck we were doing. And we came up here and had dinner. And there was a steel drum band playing. And we were drinking
pina coladas,
right? Big, thick, white pina coladas. And Lenny didn't know how hammocks worked. So I'm sitting on a hammock. And just so you know, the hammock was about right there where the volleyball net is, you know, and the restaurant was right here where I'm sitting. And I'm sitting in the hammock, and she goes over and gets two pina coladas. And she comes over and sits down. Yeah, we're doing a reenactment.
No, I don't want to fall.
You flop down, boom, like that.
Well, that was actually perfect.
That was actually pretty good. She flops down, and the hammock jumps, and both pina coladas go in the air and land on me. And so now I'm in this beautiful shirt and my shorts and I'm all dressed up for this thing and I've just got 24 ounces of pina colada on my chest.
That was probably the last pina colada we ever drank.
And probably the last hammock we ever shared.
Yes.
I would never share a hammock with you again.
No.
It's one of our favorite hikes at Bitter End. This mountain is 450 feet tall right behind us. And there's a really aggressive rock thing that you climb up. And it's the way we get our 5K in for the day. This is not so much a trail as a rock climb or a boulder scramble. The camera doesn't show the vertical incline here. Okay. It's almost hard to imagine this is the trail. This is it, right? Yeah, I see the yellow mark right there. This might be a young man's job. The whole video travel business might be a young man's job. When we stopped filming 3 years ago, I thought, I'm too old for this. I feel like there's a story to tell about the sailing fast, carbon, lightweight, and the whole taking our sailing to a new level. So I'm enjoying filming again, and I'm enjoying editing. I'm freaking loving it. We still got to go up there, so but this is the first 300 feet, but you got some great views here at the top. I think we've hit
the top.
Well, I would say the best view.
Oh, you're right, we're on the way down.
There's the Caribbean Sea. Happy together. You can tell because she's got the black carbon fiber mast.
The only one.
The only black carbon fiber mast in this fleet today. Now I'm grabbing the rope and leaning forward because this is steep. I bet a lot of people who watch our channel have done this hike. Tell us if it's hard or easy, because we often have this thing where we don't know what's a hard hike. This one appears hard to us, but you hikers might say this is nothing.